So I wanted to create this video to help set you up for success in your A&P course. So to begin, I just want to briefly cover what anatomy is and what physiology is. So anatomy is what an organ is, where it's located, and what it is composed of. So this is going to be a lot of identifying and labeling. Physiology is how each organ within an organ system works together to help you function as a healthy human being. So to set yourself up for success, the first thing you want to do is you want to create a solid schedule for the semester. So get your syllabus and look at all the dates for all your upcoming tests, all your online assignments, any papers that you have due, and make note of that in planners. And then you want to go ahead and you want to create study times for lab and lecture for the whole semester. That way you're a little bit more productive and you have a lot more structure when you're sitting down to study. So the next thing you want to do is go ahead and read the chapter before you go to class. The syllabus tells you what you're going to cover each day you go to class, so make sure you're reading ahead so you're a little bit more prepared for lecture. When you read ahead, this gives you a chance to become more familiar with terms you may not have ever heard before and concepts that are going to be reviewed. So you get a little bit of a head start, and that way you can follow along a lot better with your instructor. What I would advise you to do is if your instructor or school gives you the PowerPoints, print those PowerPoints off. If your school does not give you PowerPoints, take your book with you and highlight along as your instructor is lecturing. Get some post-it notes and add additional notes so that way you can stick them next to paragraphs so you can connect all the information now. And then as you're following along with the lecture, if there's anything that's not making sense, if you have your book and your PowerPoints with you, you can make little notes of what's not making sense. So later after class, you can ask questions or you can get some tutoring. The third thing you want to do is you want to study everything the same day you learn it. So when you're creating your study schedule and you're looking at your class and your class times, make sure you can find times within those days that you can study after class for both lab and lecture. This way you're reinforcing the information for a third time. Once you read ahead, then you go to class, and then you study that same day, that's three times you're exposed to that material. Another thing you want to do is anything that's posted on Blackboard, like worksheets or study guides, print those off and use them as soon as you get the information from class. In every single question, you want to go over four or five times in each study session, so you're really reviewing and reinforcing the information you have to know for the exam. And in addition, any online homework you get, it's not there to burden you, it's there to help you see if you understand what's going on in class, just like you would with a math class. This is helping you say, okay, yes, I do know what's going on, or no, I don't, so I need to go back and study a little bit more and read. So go through each question on your homework, use that as study time. So when you're creating your schedule, you can fit time in for online homework, and you can say, hey, this is how I'm gonna study this day. If you're going through each question on your homework, pay attention to the wording. This will give you practice for how you're gonna run through your questions on your test. And then if you get questions wrong, think about why you got it wrong and go back and read about it in the chapter, and then come back to the question and answer it the correct way. You're gonna reinforce that to your brain that you understand the information. So that's gonna help. So I kinda wanna give you an example of how you would set yourself up for the semester. So let's say you have class on Monday and Wednesday. What you want to do is you want to read on Sunday for what you're going to cover on Monday. Go to class, take your book, take notes, be very active in the information. Then you're going to go home and you're going to study everything you learned on Monday. Tuesday, you're going to review what you did Monday, and then you're going to read ahead for Wednesday. Wednesday, you go to class. You review everything you did in class. Then you go back and review what you did Monday. Thursday, spend time reviewing what you did that week. Friday, spend time reviewing what you did that week. Saturday, if you need to give yourself a break, go ahead. And then Sunday, read ahead for Monday. And then Monday, you go to class, take notes, study everything you learned Monday, and then go back and review what you did the week before, and then you're gonna continue that process for the whole semester. Yes, it sounds like a lot of work because that's what it is. It's a lot of work. This is not an easy A course. It's difficult and it takes time. So if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Good luck.